This mask making project is one that I work on with my fifth grade students. I use a water-based non-toxic paper mache paste with bulletin board paper that I've cut up into small strips. The first thing that I stress to the students is to not use too much glue and to be careful of not using enough. I begin always with the forehead and the side edges of the face because they are the easiest, and then work on the details last after they've had some experience working with the glue and paper. In the beginning, they'll need to hold down each strip, as you can see them doing, and smooth the glue out on top. And then with the glue that's already on their finger, they can use that to apply it to the top of the strip. I have them crisscross the strips in multiple directions to create a stronger bond of the paper rather than layering them neatly. And you can see I add a little bit more glue every few strips. It isn't necessary to add glue every time. Ordinarily, I have the students stand and work with the masks in their hands rather than working with it on the table because, with anything three-dimensional, you have a much better perspective if you're standing over it. Throughout the process of adding the paper to the mask form, I tell the students to smooth out the strips. As the glue settles into it, it makes it more malleable, and the wrinkles can easily be pressed out by just rubbing your fingers back and forth over them. When the students are at the point where they're working on the features of the mask, it's important that you stress to use smaller strips of paper to maintain detail and also to press those strips down even more than the rest of the mask form because a lot of times there'll be air gaps underneath if it's not pressed down smoothly. This first layer is very important, because everything is going to build off of this. So if detail is lost during the first layer, it doesn't matter how well the second, third, and fourth are done. It will detract from the overall quality of the finished product. I ask that my students do a minimum of three layers. This is stable enough to paint. Ideally, they would have 4 to 5 layers. For a lot of students, it's difficult to work at a pace where they can finish it in a decent amount of time. At the end of each layer, though, I do ask my students to spend 2 minutes or so just smoothing out the mask, adding a thin layer of glue to the top surface, and then working with their hands to press down all of the paper, especially underneath the nose and in the eyes and the lips, because those are the areas where they lose the most detail. When they've finished that, I ask them to check the profile of their mask as well to make sure that they haven't lost any of those lines of the face that are so important.